Today I want to talk about some of the physical milestones in an infant's development. When an infant is between the ages of 1 and 3 months, they can usually raise their chin off of the ground and move their head from side to side, and they might even play with their hands and fingers a little bit. So of course at this point they have fairly limited mobility and they can't really do much. But as they continue to develop, between the ages of 4 to 6 months, the baby learns how to roll over. And a lot of times the infant at this point might be able to sit up on his own and might even be able to stand with assistance from an adult. They might even start to grow teeth at this age. And between the ages of 7 to 9 months, an infant's coordination will start to improve, and they might even start to crawl and creep around the house by themselves. And by the time they're 10 to 12 months old, so about a year old, the average baby will already be able to pull themselves up to a standing position using some kind of furniture, and might even be able to use this furniture to walk around a room. A lot of times they still need help at this stage, but some children can do it on their own. By the time a child is about 15 months old, he or she can stand by themselves and will probably be able to walk without help. And he might even like to throw toys or different objects around the room. At about a year and a half or 18 months of age, the infant at this point might be considered a toddler, and he can walk sideways and backwards, so in all sorts of directions, not just in a straight line like before. When a child reaches 2 years of age, they can usually walk more steadily. They might have learned how to jump at this point, and they might even be able to run or climb upstairs with help from an adult. At 3 years of age, the typical child is toilet trained already and can probably dress and undress themselves with simple clothing. At 4 years of age, children have often learned already how to print their name and has displayed some kind of a preference for either their right or left hand. And at 5 years of age, their coordination is pretty much set, and they might even be able to dance to music or perform more advanced functions like that. And it's only in the middle of childhood when you start to notice gender differences between boys and girls. Girls are usually more physically mature than boys of the same age, and they display a higher degree of flexibility, agility, and balance. And when girls develop earlier than other girls their age, this may work against them because this may lead them to have lower self-confidence or lower self-concept. They might be dissatisfied with their physical development, and they may also display a level of sexual precociousness. Girls in this state are also more likely to partake in drug or alcohol abuse. Girls who mature later than other girls, however, are also likely to be dissatisfied with their physical appearance and resent being treated as though they're younger than their peers. Boys generally seem to be physically stronger than girls, and they perform better in activities that require gross motor movement. Early maturation in boys helps improve popularity and social adjustment, but boys who mature later than their peers probably lack self-confidence and are more likely to perform attention-seeking behaviors and might even be considered childish by their peers. And some other factors that are good in encouraging the process of development are a high socioeconomic status, a two-parent family, little visible disfiguration, and healthy parental adjustment.